I was doing a Google search on LGBTQNS people assaulted. I did a Google search specifically gay man assaulted. There were quite a few results, but the top one from April the 22nd, 2022, Florida family Mark and Enkos, that's family name, allegedly beat blind gay man. Bottom line here is they
Never see
attacked
the
this gay
sun,
man
never
and
see
caused
the
so much head
sun,
trauma
never
that he is
see
now
the
blind. They've
sun
taken away
rise
his God-given right of
again.
sight. I don't know you watch these people who committed this assault. They're
Never see
Christian!
the sun,
One of the big
never
reasons
see
this
the
story got
sun,
to me, more
never
than
see
just the
the
fact that he's now
sun
been
rise
rendered blind. When I was a
again.
teenager, I had somebody do a flying side kick into my back and damaged my kidneys. Now, I already had kidney damage from when I was very, very young, but this made the situation worse. This person got to go on and live their life normally, well, until I got them and beat the living hell out of them. But nonetheless, I do have kidney damage and I am on blood pressure medications. This Florida man, we're gonna go into this story right now. A Florida man was brutally beaten and blinded by members of his boyfriend's family because they believed the man made their son gay, according to court documents. Prosecutors allege that Ina Mark R. Enko, that's MAKARENKO, 44, age 44, and Yevhen Mar, same last name, MAKARENKO, 43, and their two adult sons, Olin, age 21, and Vlad Sav, 25, ambushed the man at his apartment in Pompano Beach last August and beat him so badly that they left him severely injured in a pool of his own blood for about 14 hours. The reason for the attack, the man told deputies, was because of his relationship with Olin, whom he had been dating for about 9 months. "Unfortunately, your son is gay," the man reportedly told Inan as the family was allegedly attacking him. The 31-year-old man has asked authorities to withhold his identity under Marcy's law, which allows alleged victims to keep information or records that could be used to locate or harass the victim or victim's family from being released. Folks, that's a very practical law to have, because a lot of these bullies slash terrorists, they won't just stop with the initial assault. They'll locate that person again and they'll go after them. They'll accuse them of things in addition to just hitting them and beating them. And the, I don't know, read the family name rather than saying it, MAKARENKOS, are all charged with first degree attempted murder, burglary with battery, and kidnapping. Prosecutors enhanced the charges for Inan, Yevhen, and Olin under the state's hate crime law, meaning the three could face up to life in prison on each of the three accounts. Well, maybe they should be organ donors. They did take this man's eyesight away. Hopefully, it may come back, or there'll be some kind of, excuse me, some kind of, treatment. Anyways, Valdis, I'll read this out, this name, Valdysslay, who does not face the upgraded charges, was extradited from Alabama and joined his family at the Broward, sorry, County Jail. Paula McHaon, that's MCHAHON, a spokeswoman for the Broward State Attorney's Office, told the Washington Post that Valdysav, Valdysslav, is expected to be charged next week. I wonder if these people even get what they've done. They're so bloody stupid. The attorney's office has accused the family of severely beating a man based on his sexual orientation. In a statement announcing the hate crime charges, prosecutors said the man has been permanently blinded, and sustained other serious injuries as a result of the incident. I'll lay you odds. Okay, these people have a Russian-sounding name. Are they from Russia? You know Vladimir Putin and his laws against gay propaganda, merging LGBT concepts in with pedophilia. Well, this is what you get. This is what it was like when I was growing up. You were a faggot or a potential child molester. That's what this young man has been is facing now. These people should never get out of prison. Their homes should be sold, their cars, everything. And the money should go to him. the person who's lost so much. I do hope that their relationship survives this and that they can be, have some kind of a life. Anyway, we're going to go on. Okay, as a result, he serious injuries as a result of the incident. He stated that the reason for this attack was because he was a homosexual, that's the person who was attacked speaking, was dating Olin, and that the family felt he made Olin a homosexual, the warrant said. Michael Glasser, the family's attorney, did not immediately respond to a request to comment early Friday. Glasser told WFOR, I think that's a TV station, that, sorry, WFOR last week, that the family denies attacking the man and said the victim's credibility should be questioned because he waited 6 months to make the allegations against the Makarenkos, Makarenkos. You know, a lot of people won't report things. There's still this blame game against LGBT people. Shame that somehow they caused it. And I was told when I was a child, it's all your fault. You're doing something to make people angry. That's why they hate you. Only you know what you're doing. It's all your fault. Anyways, back on with the story. Many, if not all of them, did not even know this person in any way, shape, or form. And they adamantly denied being there at the residence for any of the incident. Glasner told the outlet, thus far, there's really been scant and borderline nothing remotely compelling that points to this family having anything to do with this poor guy's injuries. LGBTQ issues have been at the forefront of debate in Florida. Governor Ron DeSantis, well, we know about that son of a bitch, earlier this month signed into law the Parental Rights in the Education Bill, which critics have labeled the Don't Say Gay law. Oh, drive them back into a closet and until one of them gets so angry, people are screaming, "The freak's got a gun!" Yeah, you create situations and people go crazy, they lose it. Only thing is, in this case, an innocent person has lost their eyesight. For what? Gay propaganda? Hey, Vladimir Putin? Anyways, the measure bans instruction or classroom discussion about sexual orientation or gender identity issues in kindergarten through third grade, and also empowers parents to sue a school over teachings they don't like, such as, gay people are people too. You can't cold cock a gay person standing in line. You can't kick them in the genitals. You can't poke out their eyeballs. You can't accuse them of things that they didn't do. Oh yeah, well, Ron DeSantis says, you can do that now. We're back to the good old days. Jesus hates all the gays, you know. For your secret voices tell you so. You should be on medication, but instead you're allowed to. Well, never mind. I'd say not Jesus, I'd say Satan. That's what it sounds like to me. Okay. Florida's law limiting LGBTQ discussion in schools explained. LGBTQ advocates say the measure furthers efforts in the state to paint LGBTQ community as other or even dangerous. And gay rights groups have sued Florida over the law, arguing that it violates the constitutional protection rights of free speech. Equal protection and due process of students and families. But DeSantis, oh, the great DeSantis, and his Republicans have stood firm in defending the law. Oh, it's the law! With the governor arguing that it protects against sexualizing kids in kindergarten. Well, if they learn in kindergarten that there are people, just teach kids, look, there are people who are mummies and daddies, and then there are some people where it's mummies and mummies and daddies and daddies. That's the way it is. Isn't that interesting? That's just the way it is. End of story! We treat people with love, dignity, and respect. End of story. But do they do that? No. That would be against the Bible. Anyways, let's go on. The 31-year-old man started dating Olin sometime in the late 2020s. With Olin sleeping over many times and having a key to the man's apartment. According to court records, their relationship shifted into the summer of 2021 when Yevhen, Olin's father, found out that he was homosexual, according to the warrant, and at the time when the father was treating Olin poorly and was not accepting him, Olin had also allegedly mentioned to his boyfriend that his mother was going to force him to marry a woman. On August 6, 2021, the man thought something was weird when Olin asked for his address, even though he had visited regularly for months, prosecutor said. About 1 a.m., the man opened the gate and saw not just Olin, but his family whom the man recognized from photos. The warrant said, "Olam, Olam," who the man said appeared nervous, yelled, "Go inside." Like, "Go inside!" Then the family allegedly chased the man and forced their way into his South Florida apartment. All four family members continued holding the victim and began punching it, kicking, and hitting him all over his face, head, and body, according to the warrant. When the man told Ina that Ola was gay, the victim stated one of them grabbed an unknown object and struck him in the face. After falling to the floor, he pretended to be dead so they would believe he was dead and stop beating him, the warrant said. At about 3 p.m., about 14 hours after the attack, a Broward Sheriff's Office deputy, who was at the complex for an unrelated event, noticed the door to the man's apartment open. The deputy entered the apartment and saw the man lying on the floor covered in his own blood, the records show. Prosecutors say that the man was blinded and suffered extensive injuries as a result of the attack, including brain swelling, severe bruising, multiple fractures in his facial bones, a fractured jaw, and a concussion. His medical bills have exceeded $100,000. My God. According to court records, the man, who has undergone 4 surgeries and is expected to undergo at least 2 more, has been told he will most likely never regain his sight in either eye again, according to the warrant. Despite the accusations, the allegations, supporters of the MacKarenKOS have proclaimed the family's innocence.
Oh, yeah.
An online petition in support of them describes the Markenovs, I think that's how it's pronounced, as Ukrainian refugees. Okay, maybe they were Ukrainian, who came to the United States 6 years ago and operate Thriving Door and Interior Design Renovation Compass. Among those proclaiming the family's innocence is Christina Herman, who is Olin's fiancé. She told WPLG she does not believe Olin, who also goes by Alex, is gay. "I have proof," Herman said. "I wear a ring, which is an engagement ring and one kind of marriage ring. I know Alex has his ring in jail. That is proof to me. I know we are in a relationship." But Broward Sheriff Detective Connor Ryan wrote in the warrant that the man's allegations and other evidence point to a potential hate crime. This crime was a senseless and unprovoked attack done onto a homosexual man just due to the mere fact that he was homosexual, Ryan wrote. INA is scheduled to appear for a bond hearing on Monday afternoon, McMahon said. None of the other family members has hearings scheduled as early as Friday. This is atypical. You know, we all feel good letting in immigrants, especially from the Ukraine that has been under invasion since at least 2014. And now with the 2022 invasion, special operation by Vladimir Putin claiming that it's to stop Nazis, despite the fact that the president of Ukraine is Jewish, and you can't call that Nazis. One thing I do know is that that part of the world has a lot of male toxic masculinity. And in those kinds of societies, there will be a lot of hatred towards gays and the whole LGBT plethora. They'll see LGBT people as being in the same, shall we say, boat as pedophiles. We need to be careful who we let into our countries. People have fought since before the days of Stonewall, and we just have to be careful. This family seeked out this gay man, beat him, blinded him, and fully expect that they can get away with it because he's just a fag and fags don't matter. That's the bottom line here. And there have been a lot of murders and abuse of people for a long time because of the interpretations of the verses in religious text, the Bible, and craziness.